Hey guys, my name is Eugene. This is my BMW 750 Li. And quite some time ago I had an issue with the transmission. And the transmission gave me an error. It says transmission fault. Here's 750 Li. It gave me an error message. Transmission fault, PRND, drive safely, something like that. I made a separate website as a write-up for this particular repair, and the website name is transmissionfault.com, transmissionfault.com. And basically I described to you on that website what needs to be replaced in the transmission so that your transmission would work fine. The problem was that when I would warm up the car for about 20, 30, 40, 45 minutes, and I would drive it someplace and I would park on an incline like that, like on my driveway, I would not be able to engage into gear anymore. Basically, I would put it in D, it wouldn't engage into D. I would put it in R, maybe it would engage into reverse. I would go in reverse a little bit, I would put it into D and it wouldn't engage into D, it would still be in R. It would still be going in reverse. Or for example, I would be going forward in D and I would switch to R, but it would still be going forward when I, even though it would say R going in reverse, but it would still be going forward. So this particular stick is on the wheel right there, right here. Oh, and by the way, the car only has 32,000 miles on it. So the problem, basically, I would like to show you what the problem is. The problem is this gasket right here. This is the part number of the gasket. And it's made by, the whole transmission is made by ZF Transmission. And by the way, this is the same transmission in Aston Martin, Range Rovers, Jaguars, many BMWs, not only 7 series, it's 5 series, 7 series, 6 series, you name it, the transmission like that is in many, many, many different BMWs. The list should be on transmissionfault.com, all this, every single transmission this was put in. And the problem, what happens is, this particular transmission is 6HP26, also known as 6HP28, pretty much the same thing, also known as 6HP32 or 34, and this part right here is made by ZF, right? I just showed you the exact part. But this is the part that breaks. This is made of plastic, and there's a rubber pieces here and here, so on the end there are rubber pieces. By the way, the reason I am showing you this video, if you're in Chicagoland, you could stop by and use my lift to fix it yourself. Obviously, you have to pay me something. Or you could pay me and I could replace this piece for you. It's a time-consuming process, takes about 2 days to replace this little rubber piece. And again, all the information on transmissionfault.com and the prices, current prices, maybe there's inflation going on, so maybe it's gonna be a bit more expensive than it is already. So what happens is this piece sits between the main transmission unit and the mechatronic itself, the mechatronic piece, the whole big block. Again, you will see it in the video later on how I'm removing it. So in order to replace this piece, you have to remove that mechatronic unit from the bottom of the transmission. And in order to get to the mechatronic unit, you have to remove the transmission pan, and the pan has a filter built in. So you can't just replace the filter, you have to replace the filter and the pan. And those filters are extremely expensive. They are about $140 for the filter. And the thing is, you do need to replace that filter because if you put the old filter and the pan back in, it's gonna be leaking around the edges. Again, if you're going into trouble of replacing this piece, you wanna replace the filter. You wanna replace the filter together with the pan. Because on the filter itself, there is a little rubber piece on the top that also wears out from the heat. And again, the problem, just to describe the problem, this plastic piece, it cracks right here or right here. Again, in the video, you will see where it cracked. This is a brand new piece. I'm selling those kits, the whole kit you need at the transmissionfault.com. Everything is OEM, everything is ZF. It says right there, ZF, if the lighting is correct. So, or you could order it directly from ZF, but it's going to be more expensive if you order each piece separately because of the shipping than if you buy the whole kit from me, for example. But again, you want to buy it, don't want to, don't buy it, it's fine. Again, I will try to explain as much as possible. So, what's going on here is the oil from the mechatronic unit goes upwards into the transmission. When this thing gets cracked right here, by the way, this is also the same transmission that's used on many Ford cars nowadays. So Range Rovers, Fords, Bentleys, Rolls Royces, Jaguars, again, Land Rovers, you name it, this is probably one of the most common transmissions. So before you're gonna replace the transmission, you need to replace this guy. Because whatever the problem is, it probably has something to do with this guy going bad right here. So, because of its plastic, because it's so hot inside, this piece gets broken, alright? It gets cracked. And when you warm up the car for about 30-40 minutes, the oil inside of the transmission gets really hot. So once the oil gets hot, this plastic becomes really soft. And the oil starts to go across from it, basically. It starts to leak out. And this rubber is the only rubber piece that keeps the oil from leaking out. And when the rubber gets hot, it becomes, basically the oil just keeps leaking on the side here. And the problem is the amount of pressure going through this guy upwards into transmission, basically that pressure regulates which gear you're gonna be in. So if you wanna go into the park, it would just shoot up certain amount of pressure, oil, and it will go into the park or into drive or into reverse. So when the oil pressure is not enough, it's pretty much gonna give you transmission fault message or some sort of message if you have a Bentley or Rolls Royce. Again, this is for BMW, but the transmission is all the same for all of them. So the thing is, you need to replace this thing. The thing itself is about 30-25 bucks or so. So, but if you're replacing this guy, you also have to be replacing not only this guy. This is called mechatronic bridge seal. Bridge seal because it's a bridge between the mechatronic unit and the transmission on the top. Okay. So that's that. Now, the main reason why this breaks, not so much because of the plastic, but because there are four tubes like that. Again, those are the... all of those on transmissionfault.com, all of the parts numbers are there. So you got those four tubes, 1, 2, 3, and 4. This one and this one is a different size, and this is a totally different size. So, if you want the part numbers, here are the part numbers. I seen some people replacing just this guy. But the main reason why this guy breaks, because those tubes shrink over time, over like 5-6 year period, or the more miles you get from the heat, they shrink. And when they shrink, basically your metal piece of mechatronic unit sits between the whole transmission and the unit itself. And the only thing it touches, it's not supposed to be touching, well, it's supposed to be touching metal on metal, but the interior, from what I read, is it should be sitting on those rubber pieces. So those four rubber pieces basically make a 1 to 2 millimeter seal between that bridge, between that mechatronic unit, as well as this guy is making. Basically the whole mechatronic unit should be sitting on this and those four guys right here. Now, you have to buy OEM parts because all of the Chinese stuff, I'm pretty sure, if this crap breaks, if the OEM things breaks, this is OEM stuff. If this breaks, then all the Chinese stuff. And try not to manufacture this stuff yourself, because I mean, again, from those four tubes, there's also oil flowing up and down. So if you're going in to replace this guy, you have to replace these guys. Because if you don't replace those guys, when you're gonna be securing this guy back in place, it's gonna break in about 10 to 20,000 miles. So you have to replace the four valve body seals. It's called a automatic transmission valve body sealing. All right. Now, there's one other seal right here, which leaks all the time on all of those transmissions. So if the transmission is leaking, it's probably leaking from the back of the transmission, from this mechatronic seal. Sealing sleeve, it's called. And again, it's made in Germany, that's the part number. Again, you got that on your Jaguars and your Range Rovers. This is basically sits in the back of the transmission. And in order to get the mechatronic unit out, you have to remove this guy. Removing it is easy if it's not brand new, all right? It just pulls out. Because those seals right here, one, two, three seals, they basically become really mushy and the oil leaks through it, and it's really easy to pull out. Now, to put it back in, that's what you're paying the money for, because putting it in, it took me about 2 hours to put it in. I tried Visaline here, I tried the oil all over it. It's really hard to line it up with this guy. You have to use a mirror to line up with the mechatronic unit on the inside. Visaline, everything, Vaseline, everything. And oil, everything up. Basically, lubricate the hell out of it in order to put it in. And so basically the theory behind the replacement, and yeah, you have to buy this thing new as well. So if you're replacing this guy, buy this thing as well, because I guarantee you this thing is also faulty 100%. So again, everything's made in Germany. This part right here made in Germany by ZF. It's OEM because it's ZM. This is also ZF. But again, all this stuff is on transmissionfault.com. So my suggestion to you is this: buy this kit, buy the pen with the filter inside, because the pen, you have to put a brand new pen with the filter, because the rubber around the pen is going to be leaking, and the oil that you're supposed to put in is right here. It's called ZF LifeGuard 6 right here. You need about 9 liters of that, 9 to 10 liters of that. To put it in, that's the part numbers. Now the oil is extremely expensive. Oil is about $28 a liter, and $28 multiplied by 9 or 10, you are looking at about $300 total for the oil. So you're looking for that kit about $130, $130 for the $140 for the OEM ZF pen, and basically you're looking for the 10 liters of oil, so that's $300, $430, $560 just for the parts to troubleshoot, just to replace this guy right here. Now, if you're selling the car, right, you could pretty much drain the old oil and put the old oil back in. I mean, if you're really on a budget, but my recommendation to you is buy the 4 transmission fluid, the one that's listed on transmissionfault.com, because the Ford Shell oil, don't remember from the top of my head the model of that Ford oil, but it's much cheaper. It's not $300, it's going to be around $70, $60. So instead of reusing the old fluid, I mean, you still might want to reuse the old fluid if you have an extremely old transmission, because if you put the new oil that lubricates better, the friction discs might basically not make any more friction, because the oil is much better. So if your transmission is extremely old, you got hundreds and hundreds of miles on the transmission, then my suggestion to you is reuse the old oil or if you don't have like in my case, I only had 30,000 miles. Obviously, I'm putting the 28. I'm shelling out $28 a liter for the OEM oil. So the overall cost of parts is around $560, right? And obviously, I'm not working for free. If you want to stop by and want me to fix it, then you have to pay me. And or you can again fix it yourself. The rear of the lift lifts up. There is a jack right here. It lifts up the rear. It's really stable. It's called a quick lift. It's American-made lift, which is nobody ever died under one of those lifts. And you can pull up the car forward a lot more. And the access to the transmission is not that hard. So basically, you're laying down. Hold on 1 second. How would I? Okay. So here basically you have to remove this 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the cover for the transmission right here. All right, so that's the cover, the bridge seal right there, and basically that's your pen right here. I don't think you can see that. Well, the bridge seal is right there. I will show it to you in a bit from the old video I made. So that's your pen right here, which not supposed to leak anything. And basically, the removal is, you know, if you have a lift, it's pretty straightforward. So, yeah. Right, so again, a lot more information on the transmissionfault.com, and a couple of my advices to you is, if you're going to be using my lift, pull up all the way forward right here, so that the car would be a lot higher, lift up the back so that the car would be level. The car has to be level in order when you put the fluid back in. To put the fluid back in, you need to use something like this. Hold on 1 second. Here. It's called the Mighty Wack MV6400. Not this guy, but this guy right here. And you would be able to, again, you will see it later in the video. A couple of points to keep in mind is, don't over torque these screws, because you're gonna break that plastic piece. When you're gonna putting the mechatronic unit back in, you have to put this, basically not to break this guy, don't over torque the screws, because there's a rubber pieces here, right? And if you put too much pressure on this guy, the rubber pieces basically gonna just break, and those guys also gonna break. So basically gonna get pushed in. So another thing is parking brake. When you're putting the mechatronic unit back in, you'll have to use, you'll have to see if the parking brake got fitted directly into the slot for the transmission. So there's gonna be a little tiny guy from the top, and when you're putting the mechatronic unit in, it has to fit in a certain position. So that's another thing. And if, for example, you're going to be using this lift to put everything back together, when you're putting the filter back, filter and the pen back, don't over torque the screws, but you have to check in a week if anything is leaking, because when I put that pen in, I use the torque wrench to torque every one of the screws to the factory specification. And a week later, I found out that some screws are leaking. You will see some leakage on the screws. So in a week or so, you have to retorque those screws, basically put a little bit more torque so that nothing would be leaking around the pan. So yeah. And if anybody's interested, by the way, to buy this BMW 7 Series, which doesn't have any issues with anything, always been in California and Arizona, until recently, 20,000 bucks, and it's yours. So, yeah, keep watching the video. Thanks so much.
Okay,
and
guys.
And again,
so
it's going to be a really long video.
The first thing first, you have to raise the car. For right now, only raise the front of the car because I'm not adding any oil yet, and that means that I only need the front of the car to be raised. Those ramps you see here, don't buy them. They're a piece of crap. Honestly, it's they're not worth the time and effort and the money. So, and extremely dangerous. I mean, those are extremely Chinese ramps. But since I bought them, I used them at the time. So, the first thing you need to do is you need to obviously raise the car. You need to slide under the car and remove the heat shielding around the pan. So the heat shield on this particular car has four bolts that secure it in place. That does the heat shield. And after you remove the heat shield, you wanna drain the oil from the transmission. I raised the back a little bit here so that I would have more access to the. Again, that's before I had the lift in my garage. So, yeah, you have to basically. This is going to be 10 millimeter key, hex key. And that's going to be the top one is going to be key for the 8. So 10 on the bottom, 8 for the top. So I was thinking I'm going to be reusing the oil, but then I realized that, you know, just better put the new one in. So I unscrew every one of those screws on the bottom. I don't know, there's like 28 of them or so. That's 34, I believe, Torx 34 to unscrew all of the screws on the bottom of the pan. That's the pan and the filter together, as I told you before. So that's the ZF pan and ZF filter all in one. When you're removing it, you need to be careful. First of all, you need to drain all the oil, as I showed you. And you have to secure that handbrake in place really tight with the zip ties, extremely tight. Not like I did here, but you have to do it extremely, extremely tight. Because what I did here, it was kind of loosely secured in place, but you have to tighten it up, and I will show you in the future why. So again, you have to unscrew the, first of all, the fuel plug on the top, and then you have to unscrew the drain plug on the bottom. And that's the mechatronic sealing sleeve on the top that I removed. There is not much space in there to remove it, but you have to basically pull it out from the transmission. You have to pull it out directly. All right, so again, here I use the electric screwdriver because unscrewing every one of those bolts is really time-consuming process. So once you remove the, basically don't remove the mechatronic seal yet. What I did, I disconnected the connector on the mechatronic seal. You have to rotate the mechatronic connector on the top counterclockwise and then pull out the plug. So, but before you're gonna remove the mechatronic sealing sleeve from the transmission, you have to take the pan off, and there's gonna be a white little white tab which you have to pull down. But here, what you need to do is when you're removing this filter and the pan, you need to make sure that you're not gonna break the little tiny tube that's towards the front of the pan. So you have to basically pretty much lower the pan down almost perpendicular to the transmission. So don't just try to pull out one side and then the other side. You have to remove the whole pan altogether and basically hold one. If you have two people helping you, basically let one person screw the screws while you're holding the pan and while you're dropping the pan down. And here what you want to do, you want to drop the front of the pan first and then the back. By the way, leave a like on the video below if it's of any help to you. Likes are appreciated, share, I mean, no need to subscribe, but if you want to subscribe, that's fine. So, had to put the camera aside a little bit. So right here, there should be a tube towards, this is the back of the transmission. The front of the tube should be on the different angle. And by the way, I put the drain plug back in so that there won't be it won't be leaking while I'm removing the transmission the pan. Should have fast forwarded here. All right, so I just remove it perpendicularly down, and then I remove all the oil from the pan. So that's your mechatronic unit which you need to lower from the transmission. That's the mechatronic unit, and that's the white tab you have to pull down. So you pull down on that tab, and you press down the tab and you pull it down. So press on that white tab, press it in and pull it down. So you see the little tiny sharp thing that's perpendicular to the whole arm. Press it in and then pull it down. And that's going to release your mechatronic seal, the sleeve that's towards the back and in the back of the transmission, towards the back right of the transmission. And it's really hard to get to it. And there is no room on this particular car. I hope there is room on your car. But even my hands can't really reach it in. Only my fingers could. And that's basically what's going to take you at least like removing it is going to be kind of easy. Putting it back in is going to be a pain in the butt. So I had to set the connector aside to get that plastic sealing sleeve out. Now, unless you take the sealing sleeve out, you can't really lower the mechatronic unit. This is how I'm screwing around usually to get that sealing sleeve out. I mean, it takes a couple of hours. Again, there is no easy way to get to that sealing sleeve. If anybody knows of a tool in existence that can remove that sealing sleeve out, for example, then let me know. The thing is, that sealing sleeve was brand new on my car, so it was kind of hard to remove. On your car, it's going to be really easy to remove. It's going to be really hard to put in, but it's going to be really easy to remove. If it's been at least a year old or 2 year old sealing sleeve, you can just pull it out with the pliers. I mean, and by the way, don't worry about damaging it. You still have to replace it. There's no way you can pull out the sleeve and then put the old sleeve sealing sleeve back in. So, yeah. But yeah, most of you are not going to have this particular step because most of you are going to have an old sealing sleeve. And yeah, most of you pretty much gonna spend most of the time putting the new sealing sleeve back into the transmission. And again, that's pain in the butt that you have to experience if, again, takes hours if it's a brand new sealing sleeve. That's the sealing sleeve that I was talking about. And I had to use this prying bar to pull it outwards. And I damaged the sealing sleeve in the process. But I would put a new one in anyway, so it was pretty much just fine. It's no big deal. All right, so that's 1, 2, 3. Those are like squarish like bolts. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three, four. Basically, the squarish bolts, the same as the T34 bolts, are the ones you need to be unscrewing on this particular transmission. So so the same screwdriver used to remove the pen does the same screwdriver you have to use to remove the bolts on the mechatronic. And basically don't use the electric here I use the electric on the ones that I loosened up. So once I loosen up the screws, I use the electric screwdriver to remove them completely. Now this is where the pain begins. If you're working alone, it's really hard to drop the mechatronic unit while there's limited space. That's the reason why you want to have a lift, because when the car is on the jack stands, there is really no room to screw around with the mechatronic. Okay, and that's how I removed that bridge seal right here. That's the bridge seal, you see it's cracked right there. Yeah, so that's the problem why you have transmission fault, because of this stupid plastic little, as some people call them, goggles. And you need to make sure that there's no pieces missing, because if there's a piece missing on that plastic, from that plastic, that means that that piece is somewhere in the mechatronic unit causing other issues. So you have to be looking into the mechatronic to find that missing piece. But this piece was pretty much intact. So here what you need to do is you need to pull out four more seals. But before you're gonna pull it out, like in this case, I had to remove the mechatronic unit altogether and wipe it out clean from all the. But again, that's the reason why you have transmission fault right there, basically because of that plastic piece. And here I'm gonna be soaking up in oil soon. That's like the biggest blooper of here. Like, look at this blooper. That's because the drain tube was not open on the. And basically everything spilled on my garage floor because the pan wasn't open for the drain. That was totally my fault. But again, it's better if you, again, have a lift, because doing it on jack stands, that's the cover. So anyways, here I'm basically cleaning up the floor. It's extremely messy job. Extremely messy job, and that's the reason I put the plastic covering on the floor, so that in case there are going to be any spills. Here you're looking for any shavings, but this mechatronic didn't really have any shavings, but I still wiped it out clean from any possible shavings. So had to clean it all together and inspect it. That's, by the way, if you want to replace any solenoids, this is a good time to replace the solenoids, but my car only had 30,000 miles on it, so there's no need to replace any solenoids yet. Here I'm giving you a lecture that you have to dress. All right, keep going. You see those four holes right here, the two on the right, on the top I already replaced, the two on the bottom I'm gonna continue replacing, and I will show you how to pull it out. And basically you just pull it out with the pliers, pull it downwards. In the meantime, take a look at that parking brake lever that's sticking out on the bottom right corner. There's a little lever. That's the lever that's supposed to fit your your mechatronic kit. That's how you pull it out the old seals, and basically you look at the size of the old, and you just put the new one into those areas, and basically you see how flush those seals. The one that's remaining there, it shouldn't be that flush. It should actually be sticking out like the ones on the top. So on the top I already replaced, and they're kind of sticking out. So basically, what's holding the transmission to the mechatronic, basically the connectors are the plastics, those four plastic tubes, the ones I kept talking to you in the beginning of the video, and the plastic goggles that go towards the right there. You see where the two rectangular slots basically. So again, fast forwarding here to replacing the tubes. So now all four tubes are sticking out slightly, you see? And that's basically supposed to be your vibration dampening for the mechatronic unit. So you have to replace those four tubes. You have to replace the goggles. You have to replace the ceiling sleeve in the back. And basically, you know, make sure you're gonna have a new pan and the new filter. Yep. So, I'm sorry about the discrepancies in voice overs, but doing the best I can. Again, so much material filmed, and to compile it all together, it takes a while. So, again, look at that lever right there. That lever supposed to be really fitting the mechatronic, the hydro block or mechatronic unit directly into the slots. So now when I'm going to be putting it in, you will see how it goes in the wrong way, and I have to take it apart again to put it in again. And again, as you can see, those jack stands, Chinese jack stands, horrible idea. I mean, the idea is good, but the way how they perform is really bad. So I am pretty much putting a hydro block or the mechatronic unit onto transmission jack, and I am shoving it under the car, and because I'm the only one working there, that's pretty much the only way to do it safely. But if you have somebody helping you out, then that would be great. And again, if you have a lift, your life gonna be a lot easier, and I would pay any money if somebody would actually rent a lift out in Chicagoland to me. But since I'm the only one who's renting out, who I'm aware of who's renting out, I don't see why not. So, just cleaning the area so that the mechatronic unit would fit in. And the proper way to do it is not from the side, but usually from the front. Yep. Right there. So guide it into the place. Raise it up. Again, I have to film, I have to do it, and now it took 2 days, obviously. And that's where you put the goggles in, right there. And once the goggles are in place, the four seals are in place, just lift this guy up. But when you're lifting it here, make sure make sure that that lever for the parking brake gonna fit directly into the slot. If it's not gonna fit, you have to redo it all over again. Again, I will show you in the video how I had to redo it all over again. That's a different camera again. If I wouldn't be filming it, it would probably be a lot more smoother and faster, but only people who film stuff will understand me. Everybody else would be just like, eh. So hopefully you're gonna leave me a like, because this is the most exhaustive explanation of the transmission fault issue. I haven't found a single video out there who did more explaining on what the problem is, of how to take it all apart. And basically, once you put one of the screws in, don't screw it all the way in. Make sure you have the parking lever in place. And the parking lever should fit the slot. I will show you a little bit later where it should fit. But basically, that screwdriver I'm using, it has a torque setting on it. It goes from 1 to 10. And I'm just screwing it up on one torque of one. Torque of one is like nothing. It's just made for pretty much laptop repairs, not so much for computer repair. I mean, for the car repairs. But yeah, the electric screwdriver helps a lot here, because so many screws, and basically. Here I'm trying to torque everything down to the specifications, and there's a particular order you have to torque it down with. Again, on my website you could find a link to the specific torque specifications. And again, you have to torque it in a certain order. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's probably the first one you have to torque. Then you have to torque the one right here. But I'm not torquing it yet, I'm just screwing it down, because this is not a torque range. I will show you I'm using the torque range later. But you see, once I screw down that second bolt, the first one became much looser. So those two bolts are pretty much the central settings. And they are pretty much run right under the ceiling sleeves, under the four ceiling sleeves, and under the front breech seal. But basically, if I can do it in my garage, you can do it too. You know, I'm just a programmer who enjoys dealing with cars. So, and programmer slash drone builder slash software engineer. And again, basically just follow the instructions on which screws you need to torque first. And you could just follow the video. That's pretty much how that's the proper way, basically, right here. So if you have a laptop under the car, you can pretty much see. So right here is where I realized that the parking brake is not in the slot right here, because those zip ties, the ones on the bottom, are not holding the parking brake in place properly. So I have to unscrew everything down. All of my torquing goes to hell. And once I loosen it up a little bit, I'm able to guide the parking brake directly into the slot. I would be able to. And yeah, keep in mind the mechatronic unit is heavy, so when you loosen it on one screw or two screws, it might just come through. It's not super heavy, but it's not really lightweight. You see right this area where the parking brake should be engaged directly into the slot there. Right here. Again, don't miss right there, yep. And again, the more space you got under the car, the better, because otherwise there is no way to hold it all in place. So you see all this stuff right here. You see that metal piece that's sticking out should be in between that metal bracket. So that's really important, all right? So, and the rest of the process is pretty much straightforward. Now you still need to put the sealing sleeve in the back, which is biggest pain in the butt, and time-consuming process too. All right, so just screw everything back in. Oh, probably the most boring video you ever watched in your life. But this is as useful as it will ever get, because it shows pretty much every step. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna use a torque wrench. 81.5 kilograms per centimeter. So 81.5 kilograms per centimeter is the torque wrench settings. And again, you go in the order that was prescribed, so like that until it clicks. So that's the first one. And that's the second one. And you basically just torque everything down to the proper specifications. Again, 81.5 kilograms per centimeter. And again, that's the order you need to go in. So, the detailed order you can just print out on the website again. Again, the website is transmissionfault.com. So once you put the mechatronic back in, and you put the new pen back in, you have to fill it. So that's the Mighty Wack filler, where you put in around 4 or 5 liters at first, and then you're gonna add another 4 liters or so. And that's a vacuum thing, and it takes forever to open it up, and you have to use some tools. Again, it's just another funny video. That was a brand new vac, which I couldn't open for the life of me. All right, finally. And you put ZF fluid 6 This fills up in 4, 4 and a half, and then you're gonna use another 4, 4 and a half, maybe 8 total, 8, 9, 10, 10 at the most, 9 and a half usually, what this transmission takes. So what you do is you insert one end and you build the pressure on the pump, and because the whole transmission is empty, you just fill up as much as you can, and pretty much the whole 4 liters gonna go in easily, and then you have to add another 4 liters into the pump. And right now what I'm doing is I'm pretty much leveling the car up as much as possible, because it has to be as level as can be. Basically the transmission pan should be horizontally level. So now it's the oil keeps flipping out, flowing out. What I do is I put the cap back on. I have to run the car, I have to run the car through transmissions, and basically, while the car is running, I have to add more oil in. And the car is running basically right now at this point. I'm adding oil until it's gonna be start flowing out. And I have to measure the temperature at the same time. The temperature I measure with the infrared guy. And it should be like, don't remember the exact number, but again, it's all in the little manual you could find on transmissionfault.com. And again, the car is running, I'm adding more oil. You have to add it really fast, because the transmission warms up really quick. And once you reach the proper, and by the way, the tubes are really hot, the exhaust is really hot, Once it's gonna start flowing out, as you can see here, and that's again, that's the hot exhaust, the extremely hot exhaust. Once the oil is flowing out into your sleeve, and into your under, in your armpit, you have to screw the plug, the fuel plug in. Don't shut down the car while you're doing that, because the oil gonna keep flowing even faster, even more. So, yeah, so that's pretty much the whole repair. Again, just double, again, went through all of the gears, double checking that there is a proper amount of oil. And again, how you're filling it up is, all right, again, check the temperature. Again, everything flows into my armpit. And everything is peachy. Again, you have to work fast here, because transmission warms up really fast. And went for a test drive. No more transmission fault for another 10 years. Thank you. Leave a like. Thanks. Bye.